personally, for myself, I'm more modernized. I do talk about death. It's part of my background, what I'm educated in, to deal with grief and loss. I worked in a treatment facility for a number of years, and we spoke with the youth on death and grief and helping them cope with all that kind of stuff. So it made me a lot stronger also to help, to be able to help out. But it does hurt. I can't sit here with a straight face and say it doesn't hurt myself. It does. I do cry, even though men don't cry or something like that. But I think it's one of the healthiest ways to let things go, is let those tears out and cry. From the very beginning, I'll let them talk and know that somebody's here to listen, and not just tell them, okay, you need to stop, you need to get over it or whatever. You have to allow for people to vent and mourn and grief, right? I might go through a couple sessions where they just talk or they just cry, and that's fine with me. Once they're ready to talk, that's when we start dealing with certain things, and then I'll jump into personal stories of myself on how I've dealt with them by listening to music or being around family or different tools that I was taught, like that writing a letter and saying goodbye kind of stuff. I never want people to let go of their grief so quick. I think grieving with it takes a long time. Like, I'm still grieving over all my family members, but I have tools that make me not cry all the time. I'll think about them, but that's when I'll just say, okay, I miss you guys, and then it goes away. It's just the way I was taught, and that's the way I deliver my programs and sessions with the youth.